And welcome everyone to Dr. Luke on Call, where you get accurate medical information. I'm Dr. Skalkberger, and I believe that's because of lack of knowledge that people perish. Today is a very different day, because the purpose of the video today is to tell you why the name Dr. Luke. Why not Dr. Berger? This story started in 2011 in West Africa. I went on a mission trip with Pastor Raymond Lombard to Burkina Faso. Burkina Faso is a landlocked country in West Africa, and they speak French. On arrival, most people found it very difficult to say my name. Skalkberger is not quite a French name, neither is it a West African name. So what Pastor Raymond then suggested was very clever. He told everybody in attendance that as the missionary traveled with the doctor in the Bible, so the missionary now travels with the doctor as well. And you might know that the doctor in the Bible was Dr. Luke. From that day on, I was called Dr. Luke. It was much easier to pronounce, much easier to say, and it was actually quite appropriate. Africa as a continent is very close to my heart. I traveled on a couple of journeys after that as well. We did a trip through Morocco, Mauritania, Senegal, Mali, and into Burkina Faso to donate vehicles to groups in the area. I also went on another trip to Cameroon, an amazing, beautiful country with wonderful, beautiful people. Another French country, and by then my French was actually quite good. I started learning French in 2011, and it was really helpful to be able to understand the language and even do a small devotional one morning. East Africa is also very close to my heart, and I've been working with the Ethiopian community over the last 7 to 8 years, helping their patients every second Thursday and looking after their disease and looking after their medical conditions. As far as North Africa go, I learned a little bit of Arabic and enjoy cutting my hair with the Egyptian people in our community that have really perfected the art of hair cutting. And yes, maybe they've got to look at my beard that I've grown in lockdown as well. It might have to be shaven off. Maybe leave a comment for if you think it should go or it should stay. I think my wife prefers it when the beard goes. In our own country, I love the languages, I love the people, and it's important for me to try and learn more languages to connect with people. You know, one of the most famous men in the world, President Nelson Mandela, said, if you speak to someone in a language they understand, you speak to their head. But if you speak to their own language, their mother tongue, you speak to their heart. So with that, I want to close, and from West Africa, I want to say, je m'appelle Dr. Luke. Merci beaucoup, mes amis. Que Dieu vous bénisse. From the north, assalamu alaikum. Shukran gazilan. Ma salama. From the east, inna Dr. Berger. Puttam amasin ganalo. Exabhir yabarkan. And then from the south, dingu kriha berger. Defunda ukuteta is klosa di zama zama. In kosa sekalela y Afrika. Thank you, Amal. Thank you, everybody. Stay safe and stay healthy.